So class 9, as we have started yesterday, the chapter Reach for the Top, that is second part, Maria Sharapova. So who's Maria Sharapova, this group? Stand up, put your hands down. Who's Maria Sharapova? She's tennis player, but why she is famous? Just because she is tennis player? There are number of tennis players, but why about her? Sit down. Next, Neha. Sit down. Yes. She was the number one. She has also won the Wimbledon championship. So this is the reason why her name was in limelight. And she has also turned out to be the world's number player of tennis. So this is the reason. Okay, sit down please, that she is from very simple background. Okay, not poised personality she was. And this is the reason why this chapter is being included here. Okay, so what do you know about the family of Maria Sharapova? Yes, second last boy, Sarthak. Yes, what do you know about Maria Sharapova's family? Or what you have come to know from the chapter about Maria's family? Yes. Yes, what you have come to know about her family? Sit down. Next. Next. Name, please. Shubham. Yes, Shubham. Tell me. First. How he was hardworking? Sit down. Yes. Yes. Okay, sit down, please. Very good. Her parent has played a great role, right?
Her father was working very hard to help her practice for tennis, and her mother was left behind in her career. So, restrictions, but she never let that become an obstacle in her path to success. She worked very hard to achieve what she had.
Okay, sit down, please. So just listen to me carefully. Let me recapitulate the previous chapter. So first of all, Maria Sharapova, she was quite a poised personality, balanced personality. Why? Because she has handled success so, you can say, so in a balanced manner. Okay, she has never reacted, she has never overreacted, and moreover, she knew what are my priorities and how I should do and what I should do to maintain my position. When you will come to the end of the chapter, you will come to know. Okay, so Maria Sharapova, if we talk about her family, so suppose who want to be Maria Sharapova? Suppose now let me tell you through role play. So who want to be Maria Sharapova? Okay, come here. Suppose this is Maria Sharapova, and who want to be father and mother? Okay, one of you. And father from boys. It's just a role play. Okay, come. Come. Suppose you will enjoy it. Then you will recognize and then you will remember. Okay, otherwise you people are forgetting the things. Suppose this is Maria Sharapova. Father's name was Yuri. Okay, so you will have a small paper in front of you where you will write down the name so that everybody can remember, okay? Because what you see, you always remember. What I am telling, you will forget. And mother's name was Yelena. Okay, Yelena. So what job he was doing? He was working very hard. Her father, Yuri, he was working very hard morning till evening. Why? In order to pay the fees for training of Maria Sharapova. And they both have gone to where they have gone to America in Florida. Oh, sorry, Florida in America, right? United States they have gone to. But there what happened? Yelena was not able to go there. Why she was not able to go there? Because of the visa restrictions. Now you remember, you will remember, because of visa restrictions, she was not able to go there. So what was the age of Maria when she has gone to Florida? Yes, of course. Come here to the side. Come here. Come here. Okay. So she was 9 years old when she has gone there. So Maria, what important lesson you have learned from there when you have left behind? Yes. So according to the chapter, what important lesson she has learned was that this 9-year-old Maria Sharapova, she has learned a lesson that tennis excellence would only come at a price. Okay, so which important lesson she has learned? The tennis excellence would come at a price. So now which price she is paying? That her mother Yelena, she was left behind in Russia. Okay, Russia, Siberia. Okay, so where she was living? Siberia in Russia. Okay, right? Now clear about family background? Okay, so now through Maria Sharapova, we will come to know that what kind of life she had when she was undergoing the training process. So Maria, what you have faced there? Say, I faced
bullying from my seniors. Whenever I was a teenager, I had to sleep by 8 a.m.
Very good.
My seniors would come into the room and ask me to clean the room. I had to do that because I have learned from this experience that obstacles will always come in the path to success. And I was ready to face more insults if it made me stronger, mentally strong.
So another important lesson that she has learned there was to be mentally tough, mentally strong. So how she has learned that? She used to sleep at 8 p.m. but her senior used to come at
11 p.m.
So when they are coming to room, so who will be the seniors? Suppose let us make 2 to 3 senior students. Who want to be? Yes. Okay, come. You can also come, Ayan. Ayan, come. Yes, you first boy also come. So you will be little bit aside. Okay. Now, so when they will, suppose she is sleeping. Okay. She is sleeping and you would call her. Okay. Stand up. Tidy up the room. Okay. So have the action of sleeping. In this okay, suppose she is sleeping. She used to sleep at 8 p.m. And what they are saying? Come, say to her, wake up. Wake up and tidy up the room. So you people are enjoying and now you people will definitely remember. Okay? So, what is there? So, she is sleeping. She's usually sleeping at 8 p.m. And when those two seniors, they are coming, they are always telling, wake up, tidy up the room. And what she has learned? She has learned she is not taking it as an obstacle. Okay? But rather, this is making her mentally tough. Okay. Yes, she became tougher. And what she said? When you come from nothing and have nothing, then you put your all efforts in this direction in order to achieve the limitless, right? Okay, to achieve success and to reach the summit. Okay, so till here it is clear to everyone. Okay, thank you very much to all. Have your seats, please. So now clear? Now let me ask. Okay, now Sarthak, stand up. Please have your seats. Yes, Sarthak. What you now tell me what you have come to know about family of Maria Sharapova. Yes. Father's name was? Father was hardworking, right? He was working hard to pay off her fees and keep her tennis training going on, right? Her mother, Yelena, when she was just 9 years old, they both have gone to Florida in America. Why? To get excellent training in tennis, okay? But her mother, Yelena, she was not able to go. Why? Because of visa restrictions. She was not able to go along with them. And at this time, she has learned an important lesson. Which important lesson she has learned? Very good. The tennis excellence would come at a price. Okay. Then afterwards, she was discussing about her daily routine that she used to sleep at 8 p.m. and 11 p.m. and they would call her, they would ask her to wake up and tidy up your room, right? Okay. And then she turned out to be more determined as well as mentally tough. Okay, so till here we have studied yesterday. Now coming up to para 6, otherwise we have read yesterday, so in order to make you remind, I'm starting from there. That toughness runs through Maria even today. It was the key to her bagging the women's singles crown at Wimbledon in 2004, and to her meteoric rise. Meteoric rise means smashing success. It make her rise to the world's number one spot the following year. Okay, so it means that she was mentally tough even today. Okay, so when she has achieved this women's singles crown at Wimbledon, and after that, the following year, in this after count means the next year, she has got what she has got. No, she has turned out to be the world's number one player of tennis. Okay, so you will remember this. These are the two main important achievements of Maria Sharapova. Okay, now, while her journey from the frozen plains of Siberia to the summit of women's tennis has touched the hearts of tennis fans, for the youngster herself, there appears to be no room for sentiment. See what great quality she has. While her journey from the frozen plains of Siberia to the summit of women's tennis has touched the hearts, okay, of tennis fans, it means that combination made by the writer. From where she has emerged from Siberia, which is mostly covered with snow, from those frozen plains, she has gone to the world number one player. She has turned out to be the women's tennis best player. And this, of course, moved the hearts, or this, of course, touched the hearts. This filled the heart completely with admiring sentiments of the fans. And the youngster herself, there appears to be no room for sentiment. But she herself feels that there is no room for sentiment. She should not be carried away in the wave of emotions, so that she should not forget her aim. This is the great quality of her. She was still remained dedicated. The straight looks and the answers she gives when asked about her ambition make it amply, means completely clear or fully clear, that she considers the sacrifices were worth it. The straight looks means when she is being interviewed or she is asked about her reasons of success, she is looking straight. It means looking straight means she is quite confident about the answer. Okay. And she herself knows that what exactly the answer should be. And there is no, you can say, false emotions being displayed by her. Her straight looks and the answers she gives when she was asked about her ambition, it clearly explains that whatever the sacrifices she has made, actually this success was worth of it, because she has made lot of sacrifices and she has to have achieved this kind of success. I'm very, very competitive. I work hard at what I do. It's my job. This is her mantra for success. Underline it. So what's her mantra for success? To be competitive in nature and work hard at what I do. Okay, again a lesson for us. Okay, means don't do things half-heartedly. No, I'm not. I don't want to do it. Okay, but actually I work hard at what I do. So she said, this is actually my job and that's what I was doing. Okay, and this is her only mantra of success. Then, you will come to know. Okay, means she is not carried away with those sentiments. She didn't feel that now I have come to the world number one player and then now I should stop. This is not the thing actually. Okay, I told you na. To be number one is still bit easier. It's not so easier, bit easier than that to maintain your position at number one. Okay. So many people rise to name and fame. Okay. After every other day. But how many of them maintain that position? It's very, very important. Okay. That's the actual spirit. It means that you will never feel tired after achieving one stage, but you always keep on going. And another name for life is keep going and to learn from your experiences. Okay. And life is too short to learn from your own experiences. Learn from the experiences of others. Yes. Though Maria Sharapova, she speaks with a pronounced American accent. She proudly parades her Russian nationality. Yes. Of course, she is speaking with Russian accent. Accent means the way of speaking. Why she has that Russian accent? Because she has spent so many years in America. Since she is just 9 years old, she has come to America. This is the reason she has adapted that language. Which type of culture you are prevailing in, which type of culture you are living in. Naturally, it comes to your language. Okay. But she's never denying. You can say proudly displaying her Russian nationality. She is always saying, I'm proud to be a Russian. This is again one thing that one should be attached to one's roots. So moreover, what I feel is that whatever account of famous personalities we are reading, okay? From everyone we have learned the lesson. From Bismillah Khan, we have also learned the lesson, okay? That to remain attached to your roots. He is a world acclaimed Shahnai player. He has won many awards. He can settle anywhere in any part of the world. But had he? No. Okay. But still, his heart was always yearning for Ganga, the banks of Ganga River as well as Dumrao. Similarly, she's never forgetting that although she has attained fame because of America, but she's never denying that I'm not a Russian. Okay. And means she was patriotic in nature also. Okay. So let us see the next example. And clearing all doubts, she says, I am Russian. It's true that the US is a big part of my life, but I have Russian citizenship and my blood is totally Russian and I will play the Olympics for Russia if they want me. So she has cleared all the doubts about her love for Russia. What she said that if she would ever get a chance to play Olympics, she would definitely play from the side of Russia because she is Russian. She says that Russian blood is running through my body. I'm Russian and definitely I'll play for Russia. Although that America, it also formulates an important part of my life. I have spent a number of years in America. But she's never denying that I'm not Russian. Otherwise, people, they used to feel, no, I have learned many things from here. So I want to be a part of this country. No. Okay. And when one person is a sportsman, he has this, you can say, responsibility also. He has additional responsibility for love of his country because he's representing a player. He's always representing his or her own country. So naturally for that also, whatever qualities they are displaying, ultimately the people will follow that. Okay. So like any number of teenage sensations, Maria Sharapova, she lists fashion, singing, and dancing as her hobby. So what are the hobbies of Maria Sharapova? Like any other teenager, she was just 18 years old when she rose to the world fame. And what age she was? 18 years, and she was just a teenager. And what are the, you can say, hobbies of teenagers? Singing, dancing, okay, and as well as fashion. She also want to be, okay. She loves reading the novels of Arthur Conan Doyle, one of the famous writer who is famous for writing detective series. You know which one? Sherlock Holmes. You must have heard of it, Sherlock Holmes. One of the web series was also famous for that. And Sherlock Holmes is such a character, I think so, being produced by the imagination of this great man, that not ever, ever in the history of English literature, this kind of character has been produced. And it doesn't never ever seem to be an imaginative character. It seems to be a real one. Okay. So, do you think that for writing a book, what kind of research a person is undergoing? If you have read any detective series, have you ever read any of the Sherlock Holmes? Which one? Which one? Achha, few episodes you have watched. Okay. Right, that's good. But if you will read, then you will enjoy it more. Okay? You will enjoy it more. Means, like, the writer, he has undergone through many different subjects in order to research to give this character a realistic fame. Okay? He has studied forensics also. He has studied other, you can say, other branches of science also to provide it a realistic touch. And it's really very difficult to write. Okay? If we are asked to write, for example, a story, we people feel, oh my God, what idea should I write down? But these people, they are undergoing so much of research and their hard work. It is always, you can say, seen in the kind of, you can say, the legendary books, okay? The great books they have produced. And see how many years back it has been written. And now still it is a, you can say, it is a source of, you can say, attraction for many people nowadays. If we talk about the one of the best literatures people want to read, they will definitely pick up this Sherlock Holmes. Right? So she said that, of course, I enjoyed reading this writer. And her fondness for sophisticated evening gowns appears at odds with her love of pancakes with chocolate spread and fizzy orange drink. Fizzy means filled with carbonated gas, okay? So what she's saying, her fondness for sophistication, she loves to wear evening dresses, evening gowns. Why it is seeming at odds? Can you tell me why it is seeming like at odds? But they have their life apart from sports. Whenever they are enjoying the parties, they are enjoying some social gathering, they used to wear. There, so they can't go in there that sports dress. But why it appears at odds with her love for pancakes and chocolate and fizzy orange drinks? It's actually not the reason, because after eating these pancakes, chocolate spread and fizzy orange drinks, one can put on a lot of weight. And wearing evening gowns, what it demands? Perfect balance of body, perfect shape. This is the reason. She loves wearing those. And of course, she also had love of pancakes, chocolates with chocolate spread as well as fizzy orange drinks. Okay. She's never saying that in order to maintain myself, I should avoid these. She had great love for these. So, Maria Sharapova cannot be pigeonholed. Pigeonholed means when someone is categorized into small compartments, we can separate it. No, she's not. Okay? She cannot be pigeonholed or categorized. We cannot categorize her into small areas. She has a widespread view. Her talent, unwavering desire. Unwavering means unfaltering desire. Okay, unshakable desire to succeed and readiness to sacrifice. She is always ready to sacrifice. Okay, and this has lifted her to the top of the world. So what are the qualities, underline it? What are the qualities that are responsible to make her succeed and her ultimately to lift her to the top of the world, her readiness to sacrifice, her unwavering desire to succeed, and her talent. Okay, all these things, they were responsible to make her successful. So few would grudge her the riches she is now reaping. Yes, few people, when you achieve success, not all are your well wishes. Okay, many people complain about you, she doesn't deserve this. But actually, if she has attained that success, it means she is putting some extra efforts that others are not paying, you can say, paying in. So this is what, few grudge what kind of riches she is reaping. Means she has turned out to be quite rich because they get millions of dollars as well as millions of, you can say, pounds after winning a competition. Okay. Yes, very good, very good. People always grudge the success, but not the struggle of the people behind. Okay. So she is now reaping. So some people grudge that she's not worthwhile of that success. Okay. This is what she has to say about her monetary gains from tennis. So what statement she has given about her monetary means related to money. Okay. The money she has gained. So what she has said, of course, money is a motivation. She said, yes, of course, money is a motivation for me. But why money is a motivation for me? Why she said so? Yes, she came from a very simple background. Actually, you can say she is from, you can say she had nothing. Okay. And this has instilled in her the desire, the hunger for achieving more. Okay. She did not have enough money. Her parents, how they were struggling. Okay. And tennis is a business and a sport. She admitted that. See, of course, it's a business for me and as well as a sport for me. But the most important thing is to become number one in the world. And that's the dream that kept me going. And what she's saying, but the most important thing is that I want to be the world number one player. And this dream always keep me going, that I should maintain my position at number one player. Okay. So ultimately through this chapter, it's one's struggle, one's desire to excel, one's wish to put in all the best possible efforts. These are the ultimately keys for achieving success. And she has rightly achieved it. Okay. She has put in a lot of struggle. She has sacrificed a lot of things. Okay. She has, of course, sacrificed the love of her mother also. And ultimately, these were the things that kept her going. And that's all about Maria Sharapova. So how you feel after reading this? What? Motivated. But I feel that something more should be written about her. Okay. So this is all about Maria Sharapova. And tomorrow we will discuss the question answers of this chapter. Now, if you have any doubt related to any line, which or any meaning which you are not able to understand, so you can ask me now.